there, welcome to my channel. My name is Gergő and I'm excited to share everything I know about Excel, Power Query, Smartsheet and Power BI with you. So let's get started. Okay, today we are going to automate the query we built last time, which is not more than a simple query to combine multiple Excel files from a single folder from our device. If you want to know how to do that, please check out my video. The link is in the description below. Every query has its own data source. My data source is a folder in this case, and it's very easy to change if you go back to the data tab and hit get data, and under data source settings, you can select a new folder if the data source changed or the pathway of the data source changed for your query. But this time we are going to create a macro, a code in Visual Basic to recreate or automate this query. And in order to do that, we need to go to the Visual Basic editor, which you can find under the Developer tab, hit Visual Basic, or you just simply hit Alt F11. First, I need to create a place, an environment where I can create my code and I can save my code lines. The Home tab, I simply hit Insert, Module, and I can start entering my code. Every code starts with its own name. So first we have to define the name of the macro, and the code starts like this. Sub my query automation. Open brackets, close brackets, hit enter. As you see, the Visual Basic editor automatically added one code line, which is called the end sub, the end of the code line. So between the sub and the end sub, you can enter any function or instruction to your code. I go back to my coding area and I start to set my variables. I want to set those variables because I want to create a dynamic environment. Especially the data source should be editable via this macro as well. And in order to do that, I'm going to use a file dialog box or file browser, which is a simple object in the window. So I'm going to say dim, which is the function to set variables or declare variables. And I'm going to add a name to my variable. Let's say my folder browser as file dialog. From the dropdown, either you select or hit enter. The second variable I want to set is the actual value of this object. Let's add a name to this variable, like my folder name for query. It's pretty long, as string, which is not more than a text value. The next step is to set the actual object in our code, and this line will actually appear the dialog box on your window. So I'm going to say set my folder browser equal application, which is not more than the windows, dot file dialog. I open the brackets, and from the drop down I'm going to select the folder picker option, since I don't want to select a file but a folder. I hit enter and I can continue my code. And in order to make sure that it's going to be a little bit error proofed, I'm going to set some restrictions by adding some condition to my object. And to do that, I'm going to use the with function and say with my folder browser, hit enter, dot, and I can set the conditions. Let's say the title equals with please select the data source of your query. And it's not more than just simply the title of the dialog box, which will appear at the beginning of the macro. All text should be entered between double quotes in Visual Basic. Now I hit enter, dot, next condition, let's say allow multi-select. That's an option to restrict the option to select multiple values in the dialog box. And I don't want the users to select multiple folders in the dialog box, so I'm going to say false, hit enter, and the next thing I'm going to do is to set an if statement to make sure that someone has selected something in the dialog box or they just simply hit cancel or just close the window. So I'm going to say if dot show. The dot show function will give us the value of that folder browser, and it's either 0 or minus 1. 0 means they hit the OK. If it says minus 1, then they selected cancel. I'm going to say if that show not equals with minus 1, then exit sub. So this code will stop if they hit cancel and it will do nothing. Then I hit enter and tell to the code if they don't select cancel, then I want my string to be equal with the first selected item. You just hit dot, from the dropdown you select selected items, open brackets, enter 1, close brackets, ampersand, and between double quotes I'm going to add the backslash to the value of the dialog box. because every password has to end with a backslash. And now I'm going to close my with condition, so I'm simply saying end with. I don't have to close the if statement with the end if because it's within the with conditions. So now let's test our code. I'm going to go to the tab and hit run sub user form. I hit the play icon, and as you see, it goes back to the Excel graphical interface and it shows me exactly what I want. I hit cancel this time and I go back to the Visual Basic Editor. I'm going to save my code lines, close the Visual Basic Editor, and now you will see how you can easily automate an M code in Visual Basic. What I'm going to do, I go back to the Data tab, I hit Get Data, launch Power Query Editor. The Excel will open up the Query Editor interface. So the best thing about the Query Editor interface is that all the built-in functions are applying steps to your code, and you can find them easily under the View tab, hit Advanced Editor. So my query has these code line items to transform our data, and this is what we have to auto-generate with the Visual Basic. So what I'm going to do, I simply select the M code, hit Ctrl C, I close the editor, and you will need to open up a simple notepad and paste the code there. I don't need a query editor anymore. I can close the window and I go back to the graphical interface of the Excel. And now I'm going to record a macro, but before I would do that, I'm going to delete my existing query because we are going to recreate by the Visual Basic. So I go to the developer tab, I hit record macro. In the new window, I'm going to name my macro, let's say create query. I hit OK. My record has started. I open up the notepad, I select my M code and I copy it. Then I can close my notepad and I don't need it anymore. The next step is to go to the data tab, select launch Power Query Editor, and on the query pane, right click, select new query, other sources, blank query. I go to the view tab, I open up the advanced editor, and I'm going to select my M code. Then I hit done, and my query has been created. Let's say I want to load as a table as it was loaded before. Go back to the home tab, choose close and load 2. The options are table on a new worksheet. Hit OK. Then I stop my recording. If I go back to the Visual Basic Editor, then I can see it automatically created a new module, and that's where our recorded macro has been stored. And this is the code we are going to use in our code lines as well. And now I'm going to just simply select the code what I recorded with the Excel, Ctrl C, I go back to the first module, and I paste under the end with. I'm going to add some space here just to separate the code lines. The only thing we need to do is to remove the pathway of the original data source and add our new data source as a text, what we defined via this dialog box. So what you need to do is add an other double quotes, ampersand, and the name of the variable, which is the my folder name for query. Then ampersand again, double quote. Then I can go back to the module 2, select it, right click, and remove module 2. We don't want to save it, and we can close the Visual Basic Editor. And in order to test that, I'm going to remove the existing query right now. I'm going to delete the entire sheet and the query. If you hit Alt F8, it will open up a window with all the macros you have created in the workbook so far. We have only just one. You select the macro and hit run. It will open up the window, the file browser, to select the data source. As you see, the title is saying, please select the data source of your query. Then I'm going to navigate to the folder where I have those files saved and simply hit OK. And as you see, the Visual Basic has created our query in our Excel workbook.